It is 3 o'clock in the morning and I'm very excited because it is time to go to Italy. Actually, I'm not that excited anymore. I woke up and I just realized I don't have any music downloaded. I don't have any movies downloaded. We're gonna be flying for literally a day. Like, seriously, like, I'm leaving at 7 a.m. I'm not getting there until 10:40 a.m. tomorrow. So yeah, I'm not looking forward to that. But it'll all be worth it. At least I hope so, because geez, this is tough. Yeah, yeah. I need a morning pick me up, and thankfully I think I have the right thing. You guys saw this in my last video. We have Howlerhead whiskey. This stuff is great. I love it. Wow. Hopefully we can ride this wave for like a little bit, but I think next time you see me is going to be in Italy. You're gonna see me there and the struggle will begin. We will struggle together. I'm excited to travel, honestly. Bring it on. Let's do it. Pray for me. Send me music. It'll be too late by then, but take care. Bye, LA. I'll miss you. Boys and girls, we finally made it to fucking Italy. We are out here. It is hot. I am so tired. Yeah, it's funny. I have no idea what I'm doing, but apparently I have to wait for a bus. And then we take like 9 stops. We get off, we get on a tram. I don't know. Go with the flow here, I'm not sure. We are in unfamiliar territory right now, but should be fun, I guess. I met a lot of cool people on the plane, so shout out them. You know who you are if you're watching this. So far, not much to see. I mean, it's just like a concrete jungle, lots of cars, it's a parking lot, it's an airport parking lot. I'm excited. I mean, it's hot, but it's a good hot. It's like not like overwhelming, overbearing. There's not much to do, seriously. So I'll see you when I'm in the city. Mestre, that's what it's called. That's where I'm staying for all 2 weeks. Venice was too expensive, so we're staying in the metropolitan city of Venice, basically, and should be fun. I'm excited. So I guess I'll see you there. See you in a couple minutes or however long this bus takes. So we got off the bus. It's beautiful out here. The architecture is like something obviously you don't see out there in the States. So before I came here, I said the Italian language, and me not knowing it was not gonna be an issue. Oh my goodness, we are fucked. We're fucked. I don't know how we're gonna get around this. No one speaks English. We are done. I could barely read Italian, even though like it's getting me around, but it's not enough. Anyways, it's time to check into the Airbnb. I'm not sure if the lady wants to be on camera, so I'll see you later. All right, so we made it to the Airbnb, as you can see right behind me. Not too bad. I mean, we have full access to the entire home, so that's nice of our host. This is like the biggest culture shock I've ever experienced. I mean, it's so quiet out here. I feel like I'm shouting from like the rooftops right now, but I'm really not. Like, it's just like a quiet like environment. So weird. Today I wanted to go into Venice, but I'm just so tired. I mean, like, these flights really killed me. I didn't expect it to kill me that much, but tomorrow's first day of the Venice Film Festival. I'm not sure if I can record inside, but if not, like, I'll still vlog Venice. But dude, Italy is so beautiful. Everything they say about it, it's true. Everything is true. Like, check out this view from my window. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty great, but there is a lot more to see here in Italy than just that. So see you at the next scene. I don't know what it's gonna be, so see you later. Okay, so it's the next day. I had a good night's sleep. I needed that, slept like a baby. Now we are ready to go. Today we are off to Venice. It's also the Venice Film Festival, so right now it's around like noon. So I'm gonna head out onto the island right now, just so I can figure out like where I'm gonna be at, like what's up.
Yeah, I'm very excited. Like I said, I haven't explored anything. But I think so far, my favorite thing about this place is the transport, the public transportation. It is insane. The trains and buses lead like everywhere, like airport, Venice, the actual island, everywhere. Over there in LA, dude, like it's stupid, like buses don't take you anywhere. And we literally just crossed the street. Now we're at the bus station and this bus takes us straight to Venice. Well, it's supposed to be a tram, as you can tell by the railways, but I don't know, something's going on. There's no trams going on for like a week, I think, so it's bus time. Now we wait. Venice, I think. I don't know, the bus literally dropped us off in the heart of the freaking city. I was not expecting that. And now, like, that's it, we're here. I don't know what to do now. Like, I was expecting like a fight, a battle for my life to find out where to go, but don't really need to do that now. Oh my goodness, the canals are beautiful. No idea where I'm going. Yeah, it's pretty surreal that we're here. The traveling here was such a struggle. And honestly, Venice has never really been top of my bucket list. And then I discovered that there's a film festival here and boom, sparked my interest and now we're here. Yeah, I'm already liking Venice. Very touristy, right up my alley. Loud. Mestre is really quiet. I don't like that. Gives me anxiety or something. Here though, it's nice and lively. Man, this place is insane. Like everything you look at could be like, you can hang it up on the wall like this. Yeah, but it's true what they say. It's very easy to get lost here. There's tons of alleys, like this alley I'm in right now. I don't know where this leads to. I don't know where we're going. I find it crazy that all these buildings are just sitting on the water. Look at all the like the water corrosion on the bricks and stuff. This city is truly, like truly built on top of the water. It's insane. I mean, I can see why it's slowly sinking. I bumped into like the first creepy thing here. I can't believe this is here. I walked down this alley and it's just like a bunch of these like buildings. And it's like so quiet here. They all look abandoned too. Like it's so weird having like this like super quiet abandoned feeling thing right in the middle of this big popular city, you know? First corona of the trip. Downside, I forgot my bottle opener at the freaking Airbnb. I am not a true sender, but it's fine. I'll find one. I'll ask someone for it. There's not a lot of English speakers here though. Well, we're also in Europe, I guess. It's a superior destination for European tourists, not like American tourists. I also cut my finger trying to open this stupid bottle, so this better be worth it. The goal today, I suppose, is to get on one of those, the gondolas. Very touristy, I know. It doesn't matter though, because I'm a tourist today, so it's fine. Plus, these canals and gondola rides look way better than the touristy ones, like in Vegas. The Vegas one, oh my goodness, the Vegas one is so cheesy, it's so expensive, so short. No bang for your buck there, no sir. Okay, so we found a shop. Opened it, good to go. So I took a left thinking it was gonna take us to somewhere we haven't been. We're back where we started. We are back where we fucking started. Oh my god, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know. I don't know where I'm going. Holy crap, it really is true. You do get super lost here. That's really funny. I mean, look, it's literally where we were at with the first shot you saw here at Venice, basically. That's funny. I'm glad that happened to us. Yeah, this place is gorgeous. Did not disappoint whatsoever, not even close. This is way better than Vegas. The water behind me, absolutely fantastic. We've only been here an hour. I'm overwhelmed. It feels like we've been here for like a couple hours at least. I mean, all the shit we've seen, it's gorgeous. Check this port out. This is beautiful. Oh my god, I like Venice way more than Mestre. This is it. So much fun. This is totally my vibe right now. We stopped at this pizza spot and the pizza looks amazing. Vegan pizza, easy to get out here. Also Corona, this is my second Rona in 10 minutes, so it got me really buzzed. I'm never this buzzed this quickly. That pizza place was fire, absolute fire. That was like the first Italian pizza I've had since I've been here. Fire, a little too far, because now like I feel really buzzed. It's honestly literally impossible to get lost here, because you go in a circle, you just end up in the same spot and you end up just hitting dead ends like I just did right here. That right there, that's the casino. Apparently it's not open. What a shame. I don't know where we're off to next. We have like maybe like an hour and a half, 2 hours until we have to get back to our spot. Yeah man, Venice is so much like my route compared to Mestre. It's been a lot of Mestre shade, but let's not get it twisted. I still think it's nice, you know, when you have Venice at your disposal like 20 minutes away, you'll lean towards that for sure.
Break out the red lights, welcome to the party life, welcome to the 70s. Sweet.
We're at this art exhibit. I think it's hosted by the same people who are hosting the film festival, and yeah, incredible. I'm gonna show you guys some shots right now. It's beautiful, like better than some of the art installations I've seen in LA for sure. Gangster, effortlessly. Papa was a Rolling Stone, it's in my ancestry. I'm in a whole nother league, niggas never catch me. And I sport fly shit, I should win the SB.
Baby, I said I sport fly shit, I should win the SB. I'm really in another league.
That art exhibit was fire, and it is the same people who organizes the film festival, so I think we're in for quite a treat this festival. I am ready, but we need to leave. Film festival time. We're watching this movie. I believe it's White Noise, starring Adam Driver. Should be fun, but I need to get out of here. We need to get out of here because bus rides aren't that short. I'm always late to movies in LA. Don't want to be late for this movie, especially because the ticket was like $20.
Get in. Spoiled if you're faking jack. She's used to $1 million vacations. Fuck y'all gonna do with that? When you're blue, you got nothing. Hey baby, see, when you used to flag mignon, it's kinda hard to go back to hamburger helper.
Alright, back in Venice. It's actually been like a week since the last clip you saw of me here at Venice. I've been busy at the film festival, which I hope you're ready for the footage of that. It's fucking insane. But today the goal is to ride a gondola, and I don't know, I think that's like the biggest thing today, and just to finish exploring the island. I've only explored maybe half of the island, maybe less. This place is huge, a lot bigger than what I expected, and it's because, you know, I just haven't had time. I've just been on the go traveling to the island where the film festival's at. But today's a free day. Well, sort of. We are watching a movie though, but later, like at 10 at night, so we have more than enough time to spend here on the island. There's no plan right now. I'm just gonna walk around aimlessly, see what I bump into. Oh, I also want to go to that big plaza I was talking about earlier in the video. Now, I cheated a little. I cheated, but it was at night. I did walk through it, but I didn't even realize it was it until I finished walking by it. It was empty though, and no one was there, but I want to go when, you know, there's a lot of people. I want to see what the vibe is like, obviously. There's also like this like street where like all the fashion designer stores are at. I thought it was pretty cool. It's like their Rodeo Drive or something. I do want to go to the store though. I'm thirsty. Not for water though. I'm thirsty for some alcohol, so let's find one real quick. Ciao.
Quattro cartoffi. Vuoi l'ananas?
No.
Ciao.
Grazie.
Ciao.
So we're at this massive plaza I was talking about. This place is incredible. It's even better during the day for sure. Like right in front of me, there's this massive like palace looking shit. It's incredible. And to the right of it, there's this, I think it's the huge like famous clock tower I saw on Apple Maps. I see people up there, so I'm gonna try to get up there. I don't know if you have to pay or anything. You had to pay to go up the tower at Pisa. So that was kind of dust, but I hope it's free here. I don't know the name of it, but the name of it's right behind me. I'll throw up The name of it right now. Yeah, it's fucking incredible. It's right next to that Rodeo Drive thing I was talking about, that whole street. All the designer stores, all of them. You have Gucci, Chanel, YSL, Fendi, Versace, Balenciaga, Armani, Burberry, or at least that's how I think you pronounce it. I saw Cartier, I'm pretty sure I saw Louis Vuitton. Yeah, and many, many more. It's very overwhelming. This place is actually interesting. I've seen pictures of this spot, like when it's flooded, and I thought that's what we were in for, because when I arrived, they said it was gonna be raining all week, and I was like, damn, flooded, like we are gonna be flooded. But honestly, hashtag blessed it did not rain, because you know, us Angelinos are not good with the rain, to say the least. We're good with the heat, but not that good. I heard it's 100 degrees right now out in LA, so hurry is up for you guys, that must suck. Try to go up the tower. They didn't let me in because of my tripod. These people don't like my tripod. Like on some boats, I can't take that shit. And I need to get on some boats, you know? Well, I want to go up the Pisa Tower. They said no tripods either. I don't know what the big deal is about tripods. It's an elevator, so it should be fine. It's not like I'm gonna poke someone's eye out by going up the stairs, but we'll come back some other day. Honestly, I'm glad we held off today because we've been walking a lot. It doesn't seem like it, but we've walked like maybe 4 miles at this point in a couple hours. It's fine. We have other shit to do. We're gonna try to get on a gondola now. I'm saying this right now. If this shit is more than 40 euros, that's about 40 US dollars. That's a no-go for me, homie. That is way too much. So hopefully it's not that much. Look, I just found you. How much is a gondola ride? 80 euros? Is it 80 per person or 80 like all together? Okay, all right, 80 euros, that is fucked. I'm gonna find someone to ride this with me because I am not spending 80 euros on one thing. All right, well, I didn't find anyone to ride the gondola with me, but I did bump into a guy and he said to ride the gondola down the main canal instead of where I was gonna do it. So I appreciate that. So I guess we'll just do that tomorrow. We have some time early in the afternoon. Right now though, it's nice. The sunset's beautiful. I just wanna like sit down somewhere and take it in. This place is incredible, so beautiful. I mean, I've been saying it all this time. I'm gonna continue saying it. Like, I just can't believe we are here. This was always a pipe dream. I don't know how we made this happen, but it happened. It was a grind. It was a grind saving up for this. It was a grind planning this. Only I know how exactly difficult it was to plan all this, but I'm just so incredibly grateful to be here. This is like a bucket list for so many people. For me to be here, some little kid from East LA to be here, means a lot. Damn, I'm getting a little emotional here. But now's not the time for that, cause we're gonna crack open our first shotgun overseas. European shotgun, baby. We have our shotgun tool right here, so let's get right to it. You are the